Hi, good morning friends. We will start with one more side heading, that is carbohydrate and its diseases. What is the relation between excessive or deficiency of carbohydrate and in relation of the diseases? In a previous classes we are looked over unit 2, that is carbohydrate. Among that we are discussed about digestion, absorption and metabolism of carbohydrate. We will start today with the one more heading, that is carbohydrate and its diseases. Carbohydrate and its diseases we are broadly classifying as a deficiency of carbohydrate and excessiveness of carbohydrate. Then will be call it as a deficiency means if the requirement of daily RDA of carbohydrate, recommended dietary allowance for the carbohydrate less than 100 gram will be call it as a deficiency of carbohydrate, and more than normal requirement will be called as a excessiveness of carbohydrate. Yes, we will be look what are the deficiency disorder related to carbohydrate. First one is a underweight, second one ketosis, third one hypoglycemia. When will be called as a underweight means if the BMI is less than 18.5, that person will be usually call it as a undernourished or underweight persons. Those persons are more risk to get a infection, and even though nutrition related respiratory infections and communicable diseases and several problem he will be going to face, that is related to underweight. And next one, ketosis. If the BMI recommended dietary allowance of glucose less than 100 gram, that will be cause usually deficiency. And in case of ketosis, what will be happen means our some of these systems like erythrocyte and central nervous systems are totally dependent on glucose molecules. If you are not providing proper amount of glucose molecules, those are going to become imbalanced or functionless. But our body will be having a adjustment mechanism, that is compensatory mechanism. Excessive fat is going to convert into glucose molecules. That process we will be call it as a gluconeogenesis. In case of deficiency of glucose, our deposited fat under the subcutaneous and abdomen and muscles, that fat is going to break down. There is a formation of lactic acid. That lactic acid will be produced ketone bodies, and those ketone bodies can be cross the blood brain barrier and for formation of inflammation of brains. That state will usually be called it as a ketosis, and it is more common among diabetic patient. That state will be called it as a diabetic ketoacidosis. Okay, this is how our fat is going to become utilized in the form of glucose and formation of lactic acid. That is will be said under the heading of ketosis. And third one, hypoglycemia. If the blood glucose level is less than normal, that state will be called as a hypoglycemia. Normal range is fasting blood glucose level is 70 to 110. Less than 70 will be called as a hypoglycemia conditions. And person can be having the symptoms of severe sweating and weakness, tremors and the loss of consciousness. Those symptoms are found out with the hypoglycemia. Yes, this is also will be seen in a diabetic patient who are getting excessive insulin dosage. Okay, this is how the deficiency of carbohydrate, which are those means underweight, ketosis and hypoglycemia. Next one will be jump towards excessiveness of carbohydrate. If your consumption of carbohydrate is excessive and there is no work, there is no heavy activities and there is no wastage of energy, being as a sedentary work style and excessive consumption of alcohol and adopting for the Western culture, those will be leads to excessiveness of carbohydrate. Among the excessiveness of carbohydrate, some more disorders are there. First one is obesity, second one is a diabetes, and third one is a cardiovascular disease, last one dental caries. Okay, first one is a obesity. Obesity means body mass index is more than 25 will be called as a overweight, more than 30 will be called as a obesity. Obesity first grade, second grade and third grade. The person being with a third grade obesity, BMI is more than 40. As the obesity grade increases, comorbidity and disease condition is also going to increase. Usually the person being with obesity having a several problems, mobility problems and digestion problems and walking problem and respiratory problems and even though heart related diseases, even though and cancer related defect, several things will be problem faced by the obese persons. Okay, and next one is diabetes. Among this diabetes, type 2 diabetes is more common in relation with the excessiveness of carbohydrate. Type 1 diabetes is we will call it as a juvenile diabetes mellitus as a result of deficiency of insulin. Type 2 diabetes mellitus, adult related diabetes mellitus, even though presence of proper insulin, there is no action of or utilization of insulin. Otherwise we will call it as a resistance to insulin action, that is type 2 diabetes mellitus. And all the symptoms related to diabetes mellitus, we are well known about 3 P's: polyuria, polydipsia and polyphagia. Okay, and for this treatment insulin is a good thing, and along with that lifestyle modifications, cessation of smoking, brisk walking and less consumption of fatty food, meditations for the prevention of stress situations, everything will become under heading diabetes. And next one is cardiovascular diseases. As a result of excessive consumption of carbohydrate, carbohydrate is converted into triglycerides or fat. Excessive deposition of fat in our body is going to become harmful. Those excessiveness of lipid will be called it as a hyperlipidemia state. That hyperlipidemia state is leads to cardiovascular diseases like atherosclerosis of coronary artery, myocardial infarction, angina and congestive heart failure. Several heart related diseases will be arise as a result of excessiveness of fat and carbohydrate. And last one, dental caries. It is more common among children, toddler or even the preschool children having the symptoms of dental caries. If the babies are consuming excessive chocolate and starch rich food stuff, superficial enamel layer of teeth is going to become lost. That state we will call it as a dental caries. And then this sugar will be act as a good medium for the growth and development of some microbes. Lactic acid microbes will be developed over the mouth, and those microbes will be lost the external coating of the teeth, that is enamel hard layer. This will be studied under dental caries. By this we will be conclude one more time related to carbohydrate and its diseases. Deficiency will be studied under the heading underweight, ketosis, last one hypoglycemia. Excessiveness of carbohydrate, obesity, diabetes mellitus, especially type 2 diabetes mellitus, third one cardiovascular diseases, last one dental caries. By this we will be complete today class. In upcoming class we will be detailly look over unit 3 lipids. Bye, thank you.